Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Zedd-themed dance aerobic session. Let's start with our warm-up. And as we warm up, I'll break down how this session will go. So for our warm-up, let's walk back and forth or walk in the space that you have. As we go through this workout session, we have three different sequences. Each sequence has four dance aerobics moves, so mix between dance moves and aerobic moves to get our heart rates up. I'll break all of those moves down one at a time, and then we'll go through them and dance together with the music, and I'll call out the move switches as we go. We're starting with our warm-up, we'll end with a cool down. All right, let's pause our walking and let's do arm circles. Put your arms out into a T shape or airplane arms, palms face down, left fingertips point left, right fingertips point right. Roll your shoulders forward, starting to make small circles with your arms on each side of your body. And as you roll your arms, make those circles bigger each time you go, so you work through your full range of motion. Loosening up our shoulders here. My circles are just about as big as they can get, so I am going to reverse directions, back starting from my T position and rolling backwards, small circles getting bigger each time I go around. Working through the full range of motion here. And three, two, one. Shake those out. Let's move on to glute kicks. So kick one heel back to your bottom and then bring it back down to the floor. Kick the other heel back to your bottom, back down to the floor. My feet are about shoulder width apart. Every time I bend my leg to kick my heel back, I try to keep my knee pointing down to increase the stretch through the front top of my legs, my thighs, my quads. As you're doing this, let's add our arms in. So bend your arms to a 90-degree angle or L shape as you swing them forward. So if my right heel kicks back, my left arm will swing forward and up. And same with the opposite side. Moving in opposition helps us with balance, helps us stay upright. Really get those heels back. Okay, let's trade these glute kicks out for high knees. So this time, our knee comes up to hip height, reaching up towards the ceiling. We're going to keep our arms moving in opposition. So keep that L shape or 90-degree angle. Left knee comes up, right arm swings forward. Moving at your own pace. We move from stretching the top front of our legs to the backs of our legs here. Our hamstrings. Nice deep breaths. Our heart rates are rising. And shake that out. Let's do windmill toe touches. So we'll get our feet wider than shoulder width apart, toes point forward, arms in a T shape, palms face down, and hinge at the waist. So push your hips back. Lean forward, left hand reaches towards right foot, ankle, shin, or knee. Then you'll untwist, come back up to standing. Let's repeat on the other side. Right hand reaches towards left foot and come back up to center. Repeat at your own pace. The hand that is not reaching towards your foot when you're hinged down is going to reach behind you up to the ceiling, pushing those hips back as you hinge forward. And pulling your hips forward as you stand up. We're stretching out the backs of our legs. We're still working on our shoulder mobility. We have our spine and our core twist. Big multi-purpose stretch here. Nice deep breath. Moving at your own pace. All righty, come out of that, let's move on to calf raises or heel raises. So stand with your feet about hip width apart, toes point forward. You can hold on to something for balance if you need, or hands on your hips. Heels lift off the ground and then lower back down. Heels lift and heels lower. If you choose, you can do 1 foot at a time instead of both. So toes stay down, heels go up, heels go down. Working out our calves here. Job. And shake it out. Take this time to pause and do whatever you need to get ready, get a drink of water, stretch out anything else that feels a little tight to you. As we go through this workout, please remember to modify, take breaks when need, pause, rewind, do whatever you need. Let's have a fun time. Okay, I just got water. I'm gonna break down our sequence number one moves. So for our sequence number one, our first move is shoulder squeezes. So I'm gonna start with my feet about hip or about shoulder width apart, and I'm gonna put my arms in cactus arms or goalpost arms. So what that is both my arms are bent to 90 degrees. My elbows are level with my shoulders. My palms face forward, fingertips point up. So my left elbow is to the left of my shoulder. My right elbow is to the right of my shoulder. Now, from here, squeeze your shoulder blades in together behind you. And that might cause your elbows to draw backwards a little bit. That's okay. Now, for our shoulder squeeze part, we are going to step our left foot in to meet our right. So our feet are together. As we do that, we're going to keep our arms bent in that L shape, but now our elbows are going to come directly in front of our shoulders rather than out to the sides, as if you're giving yourself a high five right in front of your face. But your hands do not come to touch. Then you'll step your left foot back out so your feet are shoulder width apart again, elbows wide, and then you'll step your right foot in this time, bring those elbows in front of your shoulders, step back out, arms wide. So feet together. It's your imaginary high five. Feet apart, squeeze those shoulder blades together, elbows draw back. Keeping that L shape or that 90 degree bend in your elbows the whole time. Elbows stay at the same height the whole time. Okay, that is shoulder squeezes. The next move is three taps and point. So let's do lower body. Lower body standing in a comfortable position. My feet are about hip width apart, toes point forward. I'm gonna take my right foot and tap it out to the right three times. So my right toes point right, tap, tap, tap. Bring it back in. Left toes, tap, tap, tap to the left, bring it back in. So that's our lower body. Let's add our point. So when my right foot taps to the right, I point to the low right diagonal. So both hands pointing low. Say pointing towards my foot. Then my second tap, my arms point directly to my right, so about shoulder height. And my third tap, my arms point up to the right to the ceiling. Step my feet back in, hands go down by my sides. Let's do it on the left. Left foot taps. First tap, my fingers point down to the left towards my left foot. Second tap, shoulder height. Third tap, arms point up and to the left. That is three taps and point. The next move is side step and punch. So let's start with our feet about hip width apart, toes point forward. And we are going to take our right foot and step it to the right. And then take our right hand and punch it out in front of us at shoulder height. Bring it back in. Feet together, hands by your side, left foot steps out to the left, left arm punches in front of you, keeping your arm at shoulder height, come back in. So sidestep and punch. Last move in sequence one is grapevine. So we're gonna travel side to side or laterally for this one. So I'm gonna start on the left side of my space and work my way right. Take my right foot, step it to the right. So now my feet are wider than shoulder width apart. My left foot crosses either in front or behind my right foot. So my legs are crossed here. Then I uncross them and then I snap, clap, hip bump, whatever you'd like to do to finish that off before we go into the other direction. So from the right, moving to the left foot steps, right foot crosses, feet together, snap, clap, hair flip. Okay, those are our moves. Feel free to revisit those directions. I will call out the moves as we switch through our songs. So first Zedd song for our theme that we will be playing is called Clarity. And we start with shoulder squeezes in 3, 2, 1. Three taps and point. Down, middle, up. Down, middle, up. Side step and punch. Right foot steps, right hand punches. Great find. Step cross together. Shoulder squeezes. Back to the circle, close arms. Three taps and point. Side step and punch. Shoulder squeezes. Squeeze those shoulder blades together. Elbows apart, feet apart, elbows and feet in. Three taps and point. Side step and punch. Great find. Step cross together. Shoulder squeeze it. Three taps and point. Side step and punch. Great find. Shoulder squeezes to finish it out. Nice job, everybody. Let's continue on with sequence number 2. Get a drink of water, shake it out, stretch anything out. Let's keep going. Sequence 2, our first move is called step forward. So it's just that. I'm going to have my hands on my hips. Feel free to do whatever's comfortable for you. step my right foot forward, bring it back. Left foot steps forward, bring it back. So I call it like testing the waters. If you dip your toes in a body of water too cold, bring it back. Try again later. So that's our step forward. Next move is side jacks. So right foot steps to the right hand raises to the right. Step back in, hands down. Left foot steps to the left arm raises to the left. And step it back in, hands down. Now you have the option to put both arms up to the sky as you step one foot out, or you have the option to take it to a full jumping jack. Both feet step out, hands go up, so body's in an X shape. Step back in, hands by your side for an I shape. That is side jacks. Next move is called diagonal heel tap. Take your left heel and tap it in front of your right toe. Bring it back. Right heel taps in front of left toes. Bring it back. And repeat. For upper body, what I personally like to do is every time my heel taps, I like to push my hands. My arms are straight. Push my hands back behind me, fingertips point down, palms face behind me, like a tricep extension. And then when my feet are together, I put my hands just in front of my torso, palms still face me, heel tap, palms face behind me. So that is what I like to do for my upper body in diagonal heel tap. Last move is side shuffle and diagonal arm reach. So we are traveling side to side again for this one. So I'm going to travel right, starting with lower body. Standing up nice and tall, feet are about shoulder width apart, hip width apart. Right foot steps to the right, left foot steps in to meet the right. So my feet are now together. Right foot steps to the right, left foot steps in, feet are together. That's lower body. Now, as we take it to the left, I'll break down upper body. So left foot steps to the left. As this happens, my left arm reaches up to the left, arm straight. My right arm reaches down to the right. So my arms, if they were one, are in a diagonal. Now, arms come back in towards my torso. So palms towards my torso, elbows are bent as I step my right foot back in to meet my left. Repeat. Left foot steps left, arms reach out into that diagonal. Left hand goes up to the sky, right hand goes down to the ground. Step together, hands come back to my torso. So step, reach, step, reach, step, reach, step, reach. Two steps to the right, two steps to the left. All right, those are our moves for sequence two. And our next song from Zedd is called The Middle. And we will start with our step forward in 3, 2, 1.
Take a seat
Right
right
foot
over
steps
there,
forward,
sat
bring
on
it
the
back.
stairs,
Left foot steps
stay,
forward, bring
leave.
it back.
The cabinets are bare, and I'm unaware of just how we got into this mess. Got so aggressive. I know we meant all good
Side jack.
intentions. So pull me
Right foot steps
closer.
right hand
Why
raises up.
don't you
Bring
pull
it back
me
to feet on the
close?
left.
Why don't you come on over? I can't just let you go.
Diagonal heel
Oh,
tap.
Just
Opposite
meet
heel
me
taps
in
in
the
front of
middle.
opposite toes.
I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle? In
Side
the
shuffle and diagonal
middle.
arm reach. Forward.
Take a step back for a minute into the kitchen, floors are wet, and taps are still running, dishes are broken. How did we get into this mess? Got so aggressive.
Side jack.
I know we meant all good intentions. So pull me closer. Why don't you pull me close? Why don't you come on over? I can't just let you
Diagonal
go.
heel tap. Side shuffle and diagonal arm reach.
Looking at you, I can't lie.
just pouring out admission, regardless of my objection. Oh, and it's not about my pride. I need you on my skin, just come over, pull me in, just
step forward.
Oh, baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little, so why don't you just meet me in the middle?
Side jack. Diagonal heel tap.
Why don't you just meet me in the middle, baby? I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle?
Side shuffle and diagonal arm reach. Just kidding, the song ended. Nice job, everybody. I just get so excited. I just want to keep going. Okay, get a drink of water. Let's go on to sequence number three. We have our first move is called lower punch. So we just did diagonal heel tap. So we're going to stick with that. So take your left heel, tap it in front of your right toes. That's the first part of lower punch, is that diagonal heel tap, okay? So if left heel is tapped in front of right toes, right fist is going to punch towards left hip. So it's a down, that's why it's called lower punch, punching down towards your hip. Then unwind and repeat on the opposite side. Okay, so one heel taps and the opposite arm punches down to your opposite hip. Next move, side step and shoulder pop. So our feet are about hip width apart, arms by your side. And we do our side steps, and we know what that looks like. So we have right steps to the right, comes back in, left steps to the left, comes back in. All right, so we have that side step, feet apart, feet together. And we have our shoulder pop. So give yourself chicken wings. So my elbows are bent. My hands are in my armpit shoulder area. So my elbows are, let's relax our elbows to our sides, so elbows point down. When you step your right foot to the right, your right elbow points right, keeping your hand where it is. So you point your chicken wing to the right. Bring your feet back, elbow points down. Left foot point or steps to the left, left elbow points left, bring it back down. So side step and shoulder pop. All right. Next move is wide glute kicks. So we did regular glute kicks in the warm-up. This time, we're just going to take a wider stance with it. So instead of having your feet shoulder-width apart or hip-width apart, have them a little bit wider. Kick your heel back to your glutes, your bottom, and then alternate. That'll fire up those glute muscles for you. All right. Then our last move is walk and kick. So you're going to walk three steps, kick forward. Walk three steps back, kick backwards. So one, two, three, forward, kick. One, two, three, backward, kick. One, two, three, forward, kick. One, two, three, backward, kick. When I kick my legs, my leg at the end of the kick is straight, whether I'm kicking forward or backward. Those are our moves. Feel free to rewind, get a refresher, get a drink, stretch it out. We go to sequence three. Our third song is called Day. And we start with our lower punch in 3, 2, 1. Opposite heel taps in front of opposite toes. Arm punches towards her hip.
Waiting for the time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind. I could give a thousand reasons why. And I know you.
And you side step and shoulder pop. Chicken wing.
We don't have to grow up, we can stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun.
Why glute kick?
I could give a thousand reasons why, but you're going and you know that.
Walk and kick. 1, 2, 3, kick.
A minute, just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do
lower
is
pump.
Opposite
heel tap.
Oh my, the clock is ticking,
sidestep and shoulder pop. Wide glute kick. Keep that knee pointing down as you kick your heel back. Walk and kick. Lower punch.
All you have to do is stay. Come in, just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay.
Side step and shoulder pop.
A second, your hands on mine. The clock is ticking, so stay.
Wide glute kicks to finish. Nice job, everybody. We're gonna go into our cool down now. So we're gonna get onto the ground. As before, just a reminder, feel free to stretch out whatever feels good to you. Your body is different, so hold things for longer, shorter periods of time, whatever works for you. Change the stretches to stretch out what your body is feeling. So we're gonna start on cat-cow position. So I'm gonna get on the floor. My hands are underneath my shoulders and my knees are underneath my hips. I have a flat back. From here, dip your belly low.
Point your nose forward. Relax your shoulders just a little bit. Stretching out our abdominals here. Now, push through your palms, curve your spine to the sky, tuck your belly button in.
Chin goes to chest. This is cat. Now, feel free to move through these at your own pace. Cat and cow.
Belly down, nose forward. Spine up, chin tucked.
Maybe you find some wiggles in here and there.
Whatever feels good.
Alright, now curl your toes under, send your hips to the sky, arms and legs are straight, upside down V-shape, pike position. Try to drive your heels down to the ground for a deeper stretch through the backs of your legs and shift your hips back to get your head between your arms for a deeper spine stretch. Nice deep breaths. And come to your knees. Let's roll onto our backs this time.
So once you lie on your back, hug your right knee into your chest. So my hands wrap around my right shin. And left foot, left leg can either go long on the ground, or if your low back is tight, you can plant the bottom of your left foot on the ground so your knee, left knee is bent towards the ceiling. And that should provide a little bit of relief there. Feel free to draw circles with your ankle, your right ankle, as it's in the air. And let's switch. Hug your left knee in. Let your right leg go. Again, right leg can go long or plant your right foot on the floor. Option two, draw circles with your left ankle. And hug both knees into your chest. Put your arms out into a T on the ground, so palms face down, arms are level with your shoulders. Let your knees fall over to the right only as far as is comfortable, and let your nose point to the left. So your left hip might peel off the ground a bit, that's okay. You might feel this in your left shoulder. Okay. Shoulder, spine, glute stretch. Come back center, knees come to the center, knees fall left. This time, nose points right. Only going as far as feels good to you. Spine, glute, shoulder, core stretch. And unwind. Go ahead and roll up to seated. Once you're sitting, extend your legs long in front of you. Legs are together. Reach for your toes, seated forward fold. If you land among your knees, your shins, that's great. Lean forward, release the backs of your legs with every new exhale you take. Release that tension. You may also feel a stretch through your spine here as well. Takes the flexibility of both the backs of the legs and the spine to get us to reaching towards our toes. And slowly roll up. Let's come to butterfly stretch. So take the soles of your feet or the bottoms of your feet together in front of you. Both knees point out to the side. So left knee points left or right knee points right. And options here for a deeper stretch. Heels come in closer to you. You hinge further forward and your knees point further left and right. To decrease the stretch, heels further away from you, sit up taller, knees come up more towards the ceiling, sky. Please feel free to stretch out anything else that you need. I will stop our cool down here. Thanks so much for joining. If you loved it, we have tons of different workouts on our channel. We have core stability, we have full body circuit workouts, we have more dance aerobics, we have seated workouts, cardio workouts, we have yoga. So please join us, and thanks for joining me today.